Okay, so this is one of my fun little math tricks that I think is really kind of cool. Basically, if you have something like a recurrence that is written like a summation, you might not even realize it's a summation until you actually spend some time with it. But see, I've got this recurrence written kind of like this. I got S sub n is equal to A sub n plus the previous term. So what I'm going to go do is also with having defined the base case for S naught is equal to A naught, that means S1 is equal to A1 plus the previous term, which is A naught. And then S2 is equal to A2 plus the previous term, which was A1 and A naught. And then, of course, S3 is equal to A3 plus the previous term, which was A2, A1, and A0. So basically, what we have here is we have a summation. So we can rewrite this recurrence as saying S sub n is equal to the sum of k going from 0 to n of A sub n. Ooh, A sub k, not A sub n, A sub k. But yeah, basically what I can do now is if I have a decent recurrence that's written just right, if I'm lucky, I can rewrite that as a summation, which is pretty cool. Okay, so the next thing we're going to talk about, because it's related, I swear, is the Towers of Hanoi game, you know, where you have like this little disc and you're trying to move the disc from like one peg to the other peg and you can't put it right there because it's too big, so you put it over there. And you got that one, you move it over there. You got the big one, oh, not that big one, that big one, and you move it right there, and then, but you can't, no, you can't move them both at once because that's the rule. You can only move one. I said one. You can move one at a time. So that one goes over there. Now I can move the middle one and the other one back on top of that. Now, this is a famous recursive problem, and we've kind of played with that around with this before, but basically, the idea is that I can rewrite this as a recursive function. So let's say I want to define the number of steps that it takes to solve this as t sub n. So basically, if I'm going to solve the t sub n problem, I have to solve the t sub n minus 1 problem twice, and then I have one extra step. Because basically what happens is if I want to move the bottom one, I've got to move the top n minus 1s, then I got to move the bottom one, which takes one step, and I have to move the n minus 1s again. So that's why I have this twice the n minus 1 thing. And of course it takes me absolutely no steps. Come on, typing. Absolutely no steps to move no disks. Now we know from previous experience with this that if we look at the numbers, we can eventually come up with the idea that this is 2 to the n minus 1 in closed form, but we're going to pretend that we don't know this right now and see if we can come up with it another way. All right, so now basically what we're going to do is kind of rely on some kind of divine inspiration, which really isn't a very good solution, but what we're trying to do is we're trying to get this Towers of Hanoi in the same situation. So instead of having a 1 there, like that one did, we have a 2. We really wish that 2 wasn't there. So here's our flash of inspiration, and later on I'll tell you how we get this flash of inspiration. But for the moment, just assume that I totally know what I'm doing, right? So for our flash of inspiration is we're basically going to divide the whole equation by 2 to the n, and I'll show you why. It'll be obvious maybe later. So whenever we have 2's, t sub n minus 1 over 2 to the n plus 1 over 2 to the n. All right. And so basically, once I simplify this, t, da, 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 and da, da, t n minus 1, 2 to the n minus 1, and if you kind of know where we're going with this, you just got like super duper excited because something kind of amazing happened. So if you look at the terms that we have right there, we have t sub n over 2 to the n and t sub n minus 1 over 2 to the n minus 1, which are basically the same term, except the second one is the same thing as the first one, but everywhere there's an n minus 1. All right, so that's on purpose. So what we're going to do is create another term, s sub n, that we're going to say is t sub n over 2 to the n, which also means, therefore, that s sub n minus 1 has to be t sub n minus 1 over 2 to the n minus 1, and therefore, S sub 0 has to be equal to t sub 0 over 2 to the 0, and t sub 0 is 0, so that means that S sub 0 is 0. Okay, so now we're going to go through here and rewrite. So we have S sub n is equal to S sub n minus 1 plus the 1 over 2 to the n, just like that. Okay, so basically now what we have is that thing that is essentially a summation. Right? That was the whole thing up here that we were trying to do. Yeah, except that I wrote stupid n, it should be a k. All right. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and write in S sub n is equal to S naught plus the summation from k going from 1, no, not from 0, from 1 to n. And we're starting at 1 because that first, in recursion, that first term is always kind of something special. And then 2 to the k, like that. Now we already have some of this, right? So we know S sub n, we know that S sub 0 is 0, and summation from 1 to n, 1 to the k, so I can also write that as k equals 1 to n over 1 half to the k. Now, the reason I'm going to write it like that is because I have some like basic knowledge of summations and stuff, because if I'm doing this kind of hardcore stuff, this other stuff isn't quite so scary. This is just something that, you know, clearly you should know this. All right, so we have this formula that if we are doing the summation, that we can reduce it to basically that right there. All right, so now we just have to apply that. The problem, of course, being that we have a 1 instead of a 0, but we can fix that. That's not a big deal. So we have S sub n. Now we're going to write this starting at k equals 0, going to n, of 1 half k. But since we started at 0, we need to subtract off the 0th term, because we have an extra 0th term, which isn't a big deal, because that's just a 1. So all this here, that matches this. So now we're going to plug in the other side of that red equation. So we have, theoretically, I suppose, 1, come here, 1 minus a half to the n minus n plus 1 over 1 minus a half, and then minus 1 over on the side. Oh, but again, making sure you recognize that this, all this green stuff, that's all saying the same thing the same way or slightly different way. So I'm not like inventing any kind of crazy math here. I'm really just plugging stuff in a basic algebraic kind of way. Okay, so now recognizing the stuff on the bottom is just 1 minus a half, which is a half, so 2, da-da-da-da-da, and there we go. And because I in no way had to come back and redo this after making several mistakes, I'm going to make sure that I do all the math right here. All right, so I've got 2, and then times 2, so that's 2 to the n, minus 1. So then whenever I come around, I got S sub n is equal to da-da-da-da-da, there we go. Now, you might say, great, I have S sub n, but who cares? And besides, I want a t to the n, and who cares, I can't fix. But I can fix the t sub n part. So I have t sub n in terms of S sub n and 2 to the n, as long as I'm careful and, you know, read this equation correctly and stuff. So basically, I can write t sub n is equal to 2 to the n times S sub n. And then whenever it comes down here, that just means I have to plug that in like I should. So I've got t sub n is equal to 2 to the n times 1, da-da-da-da-da-da, and then whenever I distribute, I get, very blessedly, 2 to the n minus 1, which is exactly what I thought to get, but I found it a different way, so there. That was amazing.